All right, ladies and gentlemen, citizens of the Empire, we are back with Mafia 2. Let's head on home and see what sort of shenanigans we can get up to as we do. Yeah, I know how going to sleep works, game. I'll do a little shopping after the next job. Or before it, whatever. Head up to Giuseppe's, maybe. How we doing on health? Not too good. All right, and to sleep we go.
Vito Scaletta?
Yeah? What's it to you?
You're under arrest for the illegal distribution of federal ration stamps. You're coming with us.
One of the gas station attendants ratted me out. The guy fingered me and they strung-armed Mama into telling him where I was staying. But they had no idea who I was working for and I wasn't about to tell them. Henry was able to get me a lawyer, courtesy of his boss, Clemente. I was up Schitt's Creek, but at least I had a battle. Could have been a hell of a lot worse if the feds knew about any of my other activities.
And I find your crime to be even more serious, considering the fact that you stole national resources at a time when our country needs them the most. An act the gravity of which you, Mr. Scaletta...
The guy was good, but even he couldn't get me out of this one. It was a lost cause from day one. 3 months later, they handed down the verdict.
Vittorio Antonio Scaletta, for your crimes against the people of this city and of this great country, this court hereby sentences you to 10 years in a federal penitentiary.
Federal pen. Thieves, murderers, child molesters, we're all here. The worst of the worst.
All right, get in line, gentlemen. Follow me single file. And no monkey business, or else.
Thank you. Let's go, assholes!
You want to make problems, you son of a bitch?
I'm sorry.
What's the matter? No speaking to English? Here, let me teach you. What, do you enjoy this, you sick fuck? Now, get your ass up and get back in line.
No!
Hey, smartass, don't make me repeat myself. Back in line.
Move it!
Stop right there. Turn to your right. Your other right.
Listen up, assholes. My name is Captain Terrence Stone, and this is my prison. You're here on the inside because you can't behave like normal human beings on the outside. Make no mistake. Your ass belongs to me now, and you'll do what I say, or you'll be sorry that you didn't! Fuck with me, and I'll fuck with your sorry ass all day long! You were sent here to be rehabilitated, and rehabilitate you, we will.
Okay, you assholes. We're gonna cut you loose. Just long enough to get yous cleaned up. Now get in line and follow me.
Welcome to the salon, ladies. You're gonna look just fucking beautiful.
Hey, me too? I ain't got nothing on my head to cut.
Shut your face, cue ball. Okay, let's go. Hey, shit for brains. Do what you're fucking told.
Okay, looks like we've been Shawshanked by somebody with a Hitler stash. This is not gonna be fun for Vito.
Listen, frick boy. If you ain't gonna do what you're told, we're gonna stick you in the hole.
Follow me. Welcome home. Get in.
Lights out!
And be quiet, assholes! You know what's good for you.
My god, that's a big-ass rat. Jesus! Right, let's lay down.
This was gonna be my new home for the next 10 years. Looked like shit and smelled like piss. I would have preferred dodging bullets in Europe to this. After 3 action-packed days of staring at the wall, I got a message from Joe to contact a guy named Leo Galante, who could supposedly help me out in here. This wasn't the kind of place where you could survive on your own.
All right, well, let's take a look around.
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Hey, buddy. Beat it.
Hey, I need to talk to Leo Galante. Point him out, will you?
Get the fuck away from me.
All right, fine.
That's 2 years. That would be, 730 days.
So how many years, then? I ain't too good with arithmetic.
5 years and almost 2 months.
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Get out of my face!
They should let me out next summer.
Anybody, you know anything?
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Fuck off. Can't you see I'm busy, motherfucker?
No, I can't. You're just sitting on a concrete slab, you dumbass.
We're in open or something?
No, we broke his fucking skull.
Shit.
How the hell are you doing? Fuck with the dogs?
Hey, I'm looking for Leo Galante. You know where I can find him?
Go bother somebody else.
Right,
new showers. Yeah,
that's fucking cool. So for just 2 years,
throw in the towel, throw in the goddamn towel, man.
So how many years?
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Never heard of him.
Okay.
No chance. No chance to serve.
Okay, he's crazy.
He's in the hall.
Okay. Obvious mental health issues.
You teach Ming basketball. Ming teach you kung fu.
All right, you got a deal, motherfucker.
Okay.
I know you.
You're that fucking guinea who was with Barbara in the jewelry store. I'm in this fucking hellhole because of you.
You got locked up because you're a stupid, crazy fuck.
You know, fellas, my mom was right. There is a God! And he sent you here, you guinea bastard, so that I could pay you back!
This looks interesting. Want to make a small bet?
All right, we got a fight on our hands.
I'm gonna break you, Diego. Come on, you
fucking Diego. Yeah, it's this fucking Diego. Fight! Get him!
Come on, you bastard.
Oh, you skinny little faggots like you for breakfast.
Huey.
Come on.
Kick his ass, O'Neal! Stop this fucking plane!
Step back!
Okay. Did you hear me?
Break it!
Get out of here! Both of
you are going to the hall!
We're gonna give you a little time to think about what you've done. Close it up.
So O'Neal almost took my head off, but I made a stand. And let me tell you something, when you're inside, it counts for a lot more than you might think.
Been there 4 days and already got his ass
How long are you planning on keeping him in here?
Long enough to learn his lesson.
That's gonna have to change. He in any shape to fight?
Should be. Boys didn't knock him around too bad after the brawl in the yard. All right, open it up. Rise and shine, Scaletta. You got yourself a visitor.
My name is Leo Galante. I heard you wanted to speak to me.
Yeah, one of Clemente's guys said I should contact you. Said maybe you could help me out.
Oh, fuck Clemente. I don't provide protection for his guys in here. But I saw how you handled that Mick who's after you, O'Neal. He could prove useful. Come with me, boy. Now listen up, fellows. This is Vito. He's gonna be helping us out. Peppy here's got a big fight coming up against O'Neal. He needs a sparring partner. And from what I saw of you out there in the yard, you're just the man for the job. You're gonna help us out, kid. In return, you'll be under my protection. And who knows, maybe you'll even learn a thing or two along the way.
I guess I can't say no to that offer, huh?
I don't remember asking. All right, fellas. Let's get this show on the road. Okay, today we're gonna work on your counterpunching. Vito, I want you to hit Pepe. Try and bust that big jaw of his. Pepe, you avoid the punch like I showed you. Then use that momentum to throw a punch of your own. All right, fellas. Let's get going.
Attaboy, oh, Pepe.
Keep that oversized chin of yours down, kid.
It's good.
Whoa! Would you look at that?
Hey! We supposed to be sparring or training?
Change of plans, big fella. This kid's got fire in him. So now you're both gonna practice your counterpunches. All right, Vito. See if you can do that again. It's a handy tool to have in the box, huh? Most guys ain't gonna see it coming. Pepe here. He ain't most guys, though.
All right, let's hit it.
Nice, kid. Nice. Give me two more of those. All right, one
Shit,
more, Vito.
That had a hurt.
Come here, Pepe. I'm Diablo.
Whoa!
There you go.
You're a fast learner, kid. All right, fellas, that's enough for today. Nice work. So how close did you get to Clemente, Vito?
Actually, I never met him. I always dealt with either Henry Tomasino or Luca Garino.
I can't believe that cocksucker Garino's still breathing.
What was your deal with him?
Well, you know, we did a couple jobs for him, and, Luca said he'd bring us into the family for, $5,000.
What? Typical fucking Alberto. He's always been a crooked bastard.
So what is that, like more than usual?
Yeah, like $5,000 more than usual.
You don't gotta pay to get in, Vito. You're brought into the family once you prove that you're loyal, a good earner. And you can handle, well, you know, the life. In any case, this is an interesting piece of news. When this gets out, Alberto and Luca are gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who?
Jeez.
Don't worry about that. We'll talk about it some other time.
Okay, get to know the guys or leave the gym. Let's talk to everybody.
Hey, how's it going?
How you doing, Vito? Name's Sal. Hey, nice work in the ring.
How you doing, Sal?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, speaking of which, you want to do some sparring?
Not for nothing, but I got better shit to do than get my head busted. Ask Al. He needs his ass kicked.
Yeah, all right, thanks. Hey, how you doing? Name's Vito.
Yeah, I know. Name's Al. Good to meet you.
Hey, you feel like sparring?
Yeah, sure, why not?
All right,
let's go.
Okay, but go easy on me, okay? I ain't a pro like you or Pepe. Keep it up.
All right,
let's do this.
Come on, give me another 20. Yeah, that's it. Keep it up.
You want to keep going?
All right, let's
go. A little bit more.
Come on, give me another 20.
All right, let's do this.
Yeah, that's it. Keep it up.
Come on.
Come on.
There we go. Come on,
Al. Yeah, that's it. Keep it up.
Hit the guy.
Come on, give me another 20. Yeah, that's it.
Hit me.
Keep it up. Come on, give me another 20.
Oh, geez, okay.
Yeah, that's it. Keep it up. Come on, give me another 20.
Good hit. All right, I'll
think. Yeah, that's it.
I think we're good, Al. Stop it.
Come on, give me another 20. Yeah, that's it. Keep it up.
Yeah, enough?
Come on, give me another 20.
How's old man Galante know so
you
much
wanna keep
about
going?
Boxing?
Never know by looking
at
him
now,
but he was a prize fighter back in
the
day. Damn good one, too.
No shit.
Yeah.
Heard he used to fight in bare knuckle matches.
How's it going?
Before he
I'm Vito.
Pro.
I'm just glad he organizes these fights. Not that there's anything
looking
else.
Looking to go a few rounds. You interested?
And he must
buddy,
be making a small
I'm busy.
Fortune on all
try
the
Al. Over there.
Matter of fact,
he didn't say anything.
Hell of a job with that asshole O'Neill. Nice. Next time, do us all a favor and snap the prick's neck, would you?
All right.
Nice work in the ring, buddy. A little more of that, and you'll be ready for a real fight.
So, what brought you here, Sal?
I felt like lifting weights, and this is where the weights are.
No, I mean, how'd you land in a big house?
I killed a guy for asking too many questions.
Okay. All right, then. See you later.
See you later.
Give me another 20.
Watch where you walk, Guaylo.
Maybe if your eyes were all the way open, you would have seen me coming, asshole.
Clemente. Crooked white devil.
Nice to see you too, Mr. Wu.
Crooked? You bet on your own guy and he lost. That's the way it works in this country.
Then Wu, offer you a rematch.
I think I can arrange that. You up to it, Vito?
Chinaman, huh? Yeah, get him a stepladder and send them over.
All right, Wu. Looks like you got yourself a rematch. And none of that chop suey crap this time. Now listen, these chinks are quick little bastards. No point in throwing big punches early on. You'll never connect.
All right. What am I supposed to do then?
You hit him quick and tire him out. When he's weak, he'll put his guard down. Then you swing for the fences. Now get out there and show him what you're made of.
Hey, does Vito get a fortune cookie after eating your guy for breakfast?
Oh my god. The language is worse than I thought. Holy shit. It's been a long while since I played the game, so just jeez.
Shut up, study more.
Well, that was quick.
This will not happen if you use tiger style.
Okay.
Let's go, Skeletta. You're late for work.
What's my job?
Hey, listen. Vito here's got the day off, courtesy of Mr. Galante.
Gotcha. Don't get used to it, Scalata.
All right. Come with me, Vito.
Got another fight lined up?
What, are we gonna train some more?
Sorta. You'll see.
All right. Leo and Pepe just waiting for us, huh? Hey, boys.
Morning, kid.
Morning, Mr. Galante. Why, no training today?
Not exactly. We got a challenge from the spooks, and I don't want to risk Pepe getting all banged up before his big fight with O'Neill. So I want you to take this one. It'll be good practice for you. Come on.
Okay.
The guy you're gonna be fighting is a strong bastard, but he ain't too bright. Fights with his heart, not his head. You piss him off, you lower his guard. That's when you let him have it. All right, here we go. Make me proud.
Looky here. I'ma take this skinny-ass white boy to school. Gonna hit him so hard his mama's mama gonna feel it. Hope you meatballs getting ready to lose.
Hey, win or lose, it'll probably be the hardest work this week.
That was a big one. Okay.
Oh, come on, my grandmama hit me harder than that. Your little cracker going down.
Laying down on a job like always.
Hit me.
Let's go, Vito. Put these bombs back into place.
Oh, this boy got as much chance of winning as a brother running for president. Man, who taught this brother how to fight?
I mean, he was right.
Now,
it only happened recently.
Finish him off. All right, kid. Now put his lights out.
Don't worry, Vito, you got him right where you want him.
Hell of a job, kid. Hell of a job. Here's your cut, Vito. You earned it.
Yo, one of the hacks is coming.
What the hell is this? Some kind of circle jerk?
All right, come on, Skeletta. You got a visitor.
All right, let's see who it is.
Hi, Vito.
Hey, Frankie. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Real good. Thanks.
So, how's things?
Well, I got something to tell you. I'm getting married, Vito.
Oh, Maron, that's great. I mean, it would have been nice if he asked my permission first, but... Hey, I'm happy for you.
Vito, you're in jail. Look at yourself. How'd you let this happen?
Hey, I already got a lecture from the judge, huh? I don't need another one. Just drop it, all right?
Vito, there's something else. It's Mama.
What do you mean? What about her?
She's sick, Vito. She's been like this for weeks, and she's not getting any better.
Look, Frankie. Go to Joe's. He's holding on to my money for me. You get her the best doctor you can find. And, you keep the rest as a wedding gift.
Vito...
No, I mean it. Looks like I'm not gonna need it for a while. All right, looks like I gotta go. Look, you take care of Ma. Tell her I love her.
I will. And thanks, Vito. Bye.
It's a damn shame.
Let's go, Skeletta. Those turlets ain't gonna clean themselves.
Great, toilet duty. Probably would be the worst toilets to ever clean. Like if an apartment building had a shared bathroom in the hallway instead of, individual bathrooms. Then again, college dorms have that, right? Which must be utterly disgusting. I don't know.
So, you're the new cleaning lady, huh? Follow me.
Hey, pal, you mind? Yo, practice that shit someplace else. Come on, man, you're killing us. Jesus, your singing is the second worst thing that happened to me in here.
There you go. Make them sparkle. And hurry it up. Hey, pipe down now. All of yous.
Relax, fellas. I'm just giving the old pipes a workout.
That's more like it. Clean it good.
All right. Jeez. No culture.
Ugh.
What's the matter? Keep cleaning, or else.
Why would you do that directly next to me? And that's the one I just cleaned, you shithead.
Hey, looks like this one's still dirty. Clean it again.
Piece of shit.
All right, that's enough. Now you're gonna go join the rest of the animals in the showers.
Get moving.
All right, Skeletta, get your clothes off and get cleaned up. Would you kindly?
Okay, shower time.
What's the hold up here? Move your asses.
Hey, Frankie. We got a little business to take care of here, huh? Why don't you go have a smoke?
Yeah, sure. Have your fun, you sick bastards.
I like your scars, pretty boy. Where'd you get them?
Sorry, asshole. You picked the wrong ass to drill.
We can do this the easy way, or the hard way. Your choice.
I got a better idea. Why don't you go fuck your buddies instead? Or better yet, go fuck yourself.
Okay. I guess you want it rough.
Oh boy, okay.
It's... Do that again, sweet cheeks. It's dirty.
Shut up.
This guy's a fighter, huh? This could have been so...
Hurry up, Joe. We got more.
Come here, you fat bastard. Got bribed so I could be molested. That's where he is.
Come on, boy, you know the drill. Oh, and this came today. Might want to read it. Looks important.
Mama died while Francesca was visiting me. Instead of going toward a good doctor and a wedding gift, every penny I had went to the funeral.
Mr. Galante wants to talk to you. Come with me. Good to have you back, kid.
What the hell happened?
It looks like the Mix weren't up for a fair fight. A couple of them jumped Pepe yesterday.
It was a lot more than a couple.
Yeah, well, we sure as hell ain't gonna let this go.
What do you got in mind?
Pepe's got it all worked out.
Took a little persuading, but O'Neill's all by himself right now in the gym. Guards won't be back for a while. You're just gonna give him a good beating. Break a couple of bones, same as they did to me. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, come with me.
Break a leg, kid.
I'll wait out here. If the guards get back early, I'll warn you.
Okay.
All right, go for it.
Hey, O'Neill. I got a little business to settle with you.
Just the man I wanted to see. Come here, Mary!
All right.
Again, harder.
Let's break his leg loose.
Nice shot, Mary. Me ma used to hit harder. Is that all you...
But that's gotta be some shit, just being in prison when your mama dies and not able to say goodbye.
No guards to save you this time. I don't think so. This time I'll finish.
Jesus, what the fuck are you made of?
Oh, you'll have to do better than that, little girl. I'm not gonna be so gentle this time.
Oh shit! No, no, no.
Had enough.
Shut the
fuck up.
It all worked out just fine. They never found out who did it. Leo arranged for me to relocate to his cell. Well, actually, it was more like a suite. Life was getting better by the minute.
So, Vito, what do you plan on doing when you get out of this shithole?
I don't know. I sure as hell ain't gonna go back to working for Clemente, I can tell you that.
Yeah, you're better off just forgetting about that old bastard. Trust me, Alberto's a real cocksucker. And you can bet that lawyer he's hired was just there to make sure you didn't rat. But don't worry. You'll get his. Letting guys into your family for money like he offered you is against the rules. He's gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who? I thought Clemente was the boss.
You obviously don't know how things work around here. You see, there's more than one family in Empire Bay. There's three. Each family controls their own neighborhoods. There's a system of rules. And if there's any disagreements, the bosses of all the families meet to work things out. That's the commission.
Great, so what do I do now? Am I in trouble too?
No. Nothing like that. You're young, you're smart, and you've proven you can keep your mouth shut. You're exactly the type of guy everybody wants working for him.
Yeah, but I don't even know who these other guys are.
There's two other bosses besides Clemente. One is Carlo Falcone. The other is Frank Vinci. Carlo is young and ambitious.
Yeah, the guy's a freaking nut job.
He's new blood, whereas Don Vinci is a man of honor. He respects the old ways.
You know these guys?
You could say that. And Frank Vinci's consigliere. You think being just a regular old man gets you all this? But listen, Vito. I'm getting out in a few months. When I do, you'll see what we can do about adjusting your sentence. Pepe, come here. Have a taste.
All right. Vito's luck turned around a little bit. Let's see what we can get up to.
Galante wasn't lying. He called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
All right, we're out of prison. Let's go see about Joe.
Break out of jail? Jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in, come in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like
this. Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going
to
need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Here. Always comes in here. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot from them inside. A much better idea about things working.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
Right, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place. We'll take my car and go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about? It's like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
Right, all right, I get it.
Wrong way.
Like an old lady.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it.
All right, I think that's a glitch. Because it's just replaying the same segment. Nice car, though.
Damn, it's okay. Good to have you home. I've done pretty good while you was locked up. But now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You seen Henry lately?
Nah, not for a few years now. He really felt bad about what happened, you know?
So what you been up to? We couldn't really talk about much when you visited me.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family, and I started working for them.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise plan for you. But don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh, boy.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
All right, well, looks like Joe's in a better spot. Probably got
what do you got, an aversion to red lights? This is close enough. Park here. Go check the place out. It's on the top floor. I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe.
Oh, right there.
I appreciate
okay.
it.
Hey, and about tonight, we're going to a real classy joint. So buy yourself a nice suit. They won't let you in this place look like an ex-con.
All right. Check out the apartment. Must be up a little further.
Okay, here we are. I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself. As you can see, it even comes with a telephone at no extra charge. And here's the bathroom, clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want. And here is the master bedroom. And there is the master's bed. It's comfy. With room enough for two, maybe three. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book. I sure hope you like your new apartment, sir. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Just one question. When are you leaving?
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check out another client. Goodbye now.
Yeah, see ya.
All right, get dressed in a suit. Is that just like six twin mattresses? Jeez. Does this count? Wait, what the hell was that? I'll turn off a light. I can't believe we're picking Joe up for my own party. coming up. Tea. Okay. Joey boy.
Jeez, I thought you was gonna be a no-show. Not bad, nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie. Here I am. How's it going?
Not too bad, not too bad. What, this your buddy?
Yeah, this is my pal Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarpa.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas, I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive? I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
He's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in the can.
Hey, what are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car.
All right, I guess I'm driving.
All right, let's go, Vito.
Hey, you know, it would help if you told me where we're going.
Head to Oyster Bay.
Jesus, dude.
Okay, so Vito, what was the one thing you missed the most when you was in the camp?
Freedom.
Yeah, well, but besides that?
Booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you're getting closer.
What are you guys, taking me to a baseball game?
No, we're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Cat house, huh? Wow.
Whoa, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
For God.
We're gonna have a ball. Oh, hey, remind me not to drink too much. There's something I gotta take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and booze?
You know how it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh?
Yeah, I'm hitting 60.
What do you got, an aversion to red lights?
So you gotta do what you gotta do. What the hell you gotta do, man? But you're gonna shotgun back alcohol and then, and get laid and then do.
So I talked to Leo Galante about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reasons.
Well,
Yeah.
Because I don't want to end up like my old man, and,
Oh, no! Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, Scram, baby. So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys.
You're right.
And to a bright future together.
Touching down.
I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of.
No.
You had a plan in 1922. You let other women
talk about a horse's ass.
Why don't you do that?
Really,
Carlo's a real smart guy. He's into, you know, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mind.
You fellas ready to go?
Vito! Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe!
If you had prepared 20 years ago,
I'm going home.
Good night, you whores!
That guy was like, what the fuck?
Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it! Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Oh, yeah, good. Hey, where's my keys?
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all us.
Yeah, you're both incredibly sloshed.
Next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less poos.
Get in.
So, how'd you like the place, Vito?
A lot better than playing I just zeech in the showers, huh?
My God.
What the hell's that stink? Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Must be Frankie Potts.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
What?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Hey, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I spätte. We'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got his spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
Okay.
You got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need to do is chuck him in and cover him up.
All right. Where's this hole?
Yeah, a little ways outside of town. There's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is.
And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air. The stench back here is fucking killing me.
How do you forget you got a dead guy in the trunk? I mean, I don't think they'd start stinking after maybe a couple hours, unless you've had him in there for days.
Stop. Now, I'm gonna hurl.
Jesus, where's this shit coming from? Oh, shit. Whoa, I don't remember eating calamari.
Can't hold your booze, can you?
Thanks for the follow, Valen K. How you doing? Valen? I don't know. I'm not good with usernames. But how are you? Right, no more vomiting until we get this guy in the ground. Thank you very much.
recipe with the help.
Okay, just a straight shot.
All right, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ.
Fucking Christ almighty! How long this guy been in here, Eddie?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Hey, mother. Hey, here's a hole. Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay. Now who's gonna bury him?
What?
I give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
Alright, let's get these two drunkards home. Jesus Christ. How do you forget a body is in your trunk?
Oh, Vito, do not change that station location. It's Dino.
Return to
me.
Me
with this.
My dear,
I'm so lonely.
Oh, God, poor Dino.
Poor Dino.
My darling, if I hurt you, I'm sorry. Oh, forgive me, and please say you're mine. Return to me.
The real question is which one of them is more off key. I think it's Joe.
This is the best part of your day.
Hey, come on, Vito. You know this song, right? Yeah, let's go. Here we go. Oh, shit. I don't know the fucking Italian words. Ah, fuck. Where's my motto when I need it?
Where's my motto?
I need it. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh, which one fell asleep? Pretty quick. Get them both out of the car before they start puking again.
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one, big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home tomorrow.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore! Come on! Look,
you had enough, Eddie. You're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
My God. Drunkenly burying a body. Jesus Christ. That wasn't the Wild Ones?
What the fuck?
Hey, Vito, rise and shine!
Jesus! Marty, stop fucking yelling, will you? My head's killing me.
Sorry, Joey.
Stop calling me fucking Joey. What the hell's wrong with you? Vito, come on down!
Jesus Christ.
Okay, wow. That was an eventful night, and it started with an eventful morning. Dear Lord. All right, ladies, gentlemen, citizens of the Empire, thanks so very much for joining me. If you're watching on YouTube, please like, comment, subscribe on Twitch. Drop me a follow if you haven't already, and I will see you all tomorrow.